This is an artificial intelligence license plate reader that I installed in my car. It uses AI to detect a license plate, convert it to text, and then check if that plate is registered by looking up the Victorian Vehicles Register website. Now, you'd expect technology like this to be worth thousands of dollars, or more specifically, $78,636, because that's how much it costs Victoria Police on average to fit automatic number plate recognition into their cars. But my solution only ended up costing a few hundred dollars, so let me show you how I built it. On the hardware front, I have a USB 3 camera with a 23mm lens, which gives me really clear vision of license plates that are as far as 10 meters away. That camera is then wired through the engine bay, through the passenger firewall, and into the glove compartment, which connects to this tiny ASUS Tinker HT single board computer. This is the computer that does the AI plate detection and vehicle registration check. From that, we have a HDMI cable that connects to a portable monitor and a 12-volt battery pack to power the computer. As for internet, I'm tethering from my phone. On the software front, I trained a deep learning model with TensorFlow Lite using over 300 images of Victorian license plates via transfer learning, and then wrote an app in Python to detect license plates and check that plate against the Victorian Vehicles Register website. Put this all together, and for about $764, you have an automatic license plate reader in your car. So let's see how well this thing works by starting with a few basic unit tests. I'm going to walk about 10 meters away, hold up some license plates that I photoshopped and printed out on A4 paper. The main window here is the ASUS Tinker HT, which is hooked up to the portable monitor. The right side is my Pixel 4a recording next to the car. Just look at how much more zoomed in the 23mm lens is compared to a phone camera. Our first plate is A55. Now you can see that our model is detecting the plate, but it's failing to convert it to text. I think it might be a bit too small. Let's move on to the next plate, which is Flick. You can see that it's detected the plate again, and this time it's converted the text with 83% confidence. The last test is Pen15. The model detects the plate, but it reads it as PEH15 with the highest level of confidence. With thorough testing done, it's time to hit the road. Let's start easy in a parking lot. When both cars are stationary, it works perfectly. It detected the plate, converted it to text, and returned the details of the car. It's paid its rego until the 25th of September. It's a 2017 Hyundai sedan with the VIN and engine number. The app then summarizes that detail into this data frame here that shows the rego number, if the rego has been paid, and if there's any sanctions or fines on the rego. If everything's okay, it'll return a circle, and if it's not okay, it'll show an X in red. Now let's move on to driving on the road. At low speeds and stopping at intersections, it performed quite well. Once it locked onto a plate, it took between 5 to 10 seconds to convert the text and return results from the VVR. In daylight, where plates with a white background and blue text that follow the number, letter, pattern, the plate reader worked beautifully. Now, the camera resolution is 480, which outputs about 20 to 30 frames per second. If I used anything more than 480, the frame rate drops significantly, which is why you're only seeing the app take up a portion of the 1080 screen. Now, let's look at instances where this didn't work quite well. On several occasions, my app really struggled to tell the difference between O's, zeros, and Q. Here you can see the plate is SZO, but it's reading it as SZQ, which comes back as RNF or record not found. Here's another example of O being read as Q. Again, this image looks crystal clear to me, but it still reads it as Q. I used the OpenALPR library to convert the image to text, and as amazing as that library is, I just couldn't figure out a way around this. If you have any ideas, let me know in the comments. Then here's some other instances where it didn't work quite well. This one looks really clear to me, but it only reads the first four characters. I suspect the plate is just a bit too small and my app needs to make it bigger. Black colored plates struggled, which is why I think my unit tests didn't go so well, but I know the solution is just to do a bit of pre-processing on the image. Then license plates with plastic trim in front of it had issues because there was just too much reflection from them. And lastly, the app didn't work well at all in low light when the sun was going down. The text on the plate either became too dark to read, or my headlights reflected too much off the plate, which made it hard to read. You can see it just looks like a hot blurry mess, and this is pretty much why Victoria Police have way better technology in their cars than what I've put together. So there you have it, that's my automatic license plate recognition system. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts are or if you're interested in building one yourself. That's it for this one. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe because it really helps me out, and I'll catch you in the next one. See you later.